Hi everyone, welcome to the School Marketing Show Live. My name is Kristen, and as always, I am joined by my fellow final site marketer, Mia. If you are new to the show, welcome. And just to tell you a little bit about it, here at Final Site, professional development and education are really a big piece of our culture. So we use this show as a way to get in touch with schools and districts around the world on the topics that matter most to you. So we're talking marketing, communications, admissions, advancement, you name it, we cover it. And I would encourage you throughout the show, let us know in the comments what you're most interested in learning so that we can cover it in a future episode. So, last episode, on episode 14, we talked about how to get families to actually read your emails. You know, it's a tough task to accomplish, but we talked through some tips you can do to encourage that read-through rate. But kind of heading into the holiday season, this can be an increasingly difficult task because we're heading into a very busy season. So the question kind of stands, how do we engage with our families as we head into, say, Thanksgiving? So, today we're actually going to talk about how you can effectively celebrate and engage with your community during Thanksgiving. And we know this is very specific to the US, but I would say these tips can last you all year long when you're thinking about your emails, social media, video, and so on. So, in today's episode, we are going to cover first how to use email at Thanksgiving, what you can do, how you can engage with your community. Second, what you can do on social media. And then third, how to use video during this time. And finally, what are the actual tangible pieces of content you can put together during this season? So if you're feeling a little stuck in your communications right now as we head into Thanksgiving, I'd encourage you to stop what you're doing and strategize with us. Now, Mia, since we did talk about email last week, and I know you've seen so many examples throughout the years of schools using email at Thanksgiving, how would you recommend that schools use email during this time?
Yeah, Kristen. So the first thing that we want to keep in mind, and I think this is going to be true for our social media as well, is that email inboxes are busier than ever. And I'm sure as a school, you are sending emails to parents' personal emails, which are the emails where they're also getting promo codes for Black Friday and retargeting emails that someone left their new comforter and their Pottery Barn cart and all sorts of other emails that you're going to be competing with. And because it's the holidays, there's already going to be more than ever. So time is of the essence here. So we really don't want to wait until, I don't know, the day before Thanksgiving to send that email because people are already checked out. They're planning for their COVID-friendly Thanksgiving festivities. They're planning for Black Friday. They might already be doing some shopping and they might actually miss that email from you. So the first thing we want to do is we want to take timing into consideration. So if your school, let's say, is closed the entire week of Thanksgiving, be sure to send this email the week before so that they're expecting a communication from you. If you send it that week that you're closed, they might miss it, especially because it's going to be in that flurry of those retail emails that they're going to be receiving. You can also aim to send it, the day that you close for holiday break, but we just want to time it so that parents are almost expecting to receive that communication because you are, closing for a week or a few days or whatever that may be. So timing is key here. And then of course, that subject line is key too. We want to make sure that we include words in that subject line like deserve, gratitude, and thankful, and make sure that it comes from a person. We don't just want something to come from a do not reply address. A lot of the same best practices that we talked about a few episodes ago in that talking about how to get people to open your email. So throw a turkey emoji in there, throw in an orange heart. Just be sure that, we express that there is a special Thanksgiving message of gratitude there in that email inbox. Now, once we've actually hit the timing right and we've gotten them to open our email, what we want to do is we want to make sure that we express our gratitude in a very authentic way that resonates with who our school is, like what our normal mission is, what our normal messaging is, what our normal value proposition is, but also in relation to obviously what a whirlwind this year has been. And I do want to go so far as to say is that your message should go beyond just communicating with your parents. We should definitely be having a separate thank you message being sent to our teachers this year, our parents, and even our students, because everyone has had different obstacles to overcome and different achievements. And I think normally in the past, we might have just sent like a typical, like, hey, thanks. We're so thankful for you, which was pretty easy to get away with. This year, our parents deserve a different thank you than our teachers do, and our teachers deserve a different thank you than our students do. And I think that if you can nail down that messaging and find a way to segment it so you can hit all of those target markets, that's going to be really key here. Now, when it comes to sending the email, you can keep it simple. You can have a simple graphic at the top that just says, Happy Thanksgiving, or, you know, this year we're celebrating gratitude, or this year we're celebrating you. We're so thankful for you and all that you do. Just making sure that that message of gratitude and thankfulness is in there. So you can use a graphic, you can use plain text. It can come from your head of school. It can come from your superintendent. So that's kind of the simplest way to send the email, especially, I mean, we're looking at about 2 weeks until we'd send that email, maybe even less. So if you don't have the ability to put together something, you know, that might require some more production, which we'll talk about in a second, sending out that plain text email is totally fine. But we just want to make sure that that message is segmented and that it is authentic and speaks to the unique challenges that your school has faced this year. Now, if you wanted to kick it up a notch, obviously a video message could be super compelling. And again, we might want to use this opportunity to diversify our message based on who's receiving it, or it's a really good opportunity to bring all of those voices together. So while a video might seem like it's more production quality, it's also an opportunity to reach all those target audiences at once by bringing them all together in one video. So a simple video where you might have a series of talking heads saying, you know, thank you for adapting and, you know, thank you for sticking by us and thank you for showing up and masking up and having all those different people kind of share one long message is not difficult to produce and can be done completely over Zoom for our schools that are, you know, still working in a hybrid or remote environment. So looking at plain text, image, or video here, and then of course, considering that segmentation and your timing here is going to be key. Now with email, we're really thinking of only sending one thing one time because we don't want to be additional noise in those inboxes. But Kristen, on social media in particular, there's a lot that we can do continuously throughout the rest of this month to celebrate our community. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think Thanksgiving season, it couldn't be a better time to ramp up your social media content because when you're thinking about Thanksgiving and gratitude, really you're looking at showcasing your community. You're looking at not exactly asking for something in return. And those things together are really the perfect recipe for great social media engagement opportunities. So now's the time to do it 100% all month long. I would say if you are already putting together some content for an email, like Mia just mentioned, you can definitely take snippets of it to post on social media. It's a great opportunity to plan out your content ahead of time, maybe schedule some things ahead of time so that you can, you know, just let it run and post while you maybe are on break. So, you know, sharing maybe that same Happy Thanksgiving graphic that Mia mentioned you could put in your email, sharing photos of your campus, you know, celebrating years of philanthropy, thanking your community for all of the hard work they've put in this year. All the same content you would think about putting in that email, you definitely want to think about, you know, spreading out over the course of the entire month of November on social media. So I would say, I mean, when you are thinking about celebrating your community, it's sometimes the easiest content to put together. And this is the one time of year you absolutely cannot overdo it. You know, there's nothing, there's no too much in terms of celebrating your community, especially during November. So consider doing, you know, maybe a week of thankfulness, maybe the week before Thanksgiving, posting something once a day, thanking your faculty, thanking your students, thanking your parents, you know, your entire community, all of the hard work they've put in this year. Or you could even think, and I will say, if you haven't grabbed our fall/winter social media calendar, we can drop a link to it in the comments, but it does suggest during the month of November, you could try something like swapping out your typical Throwback Thursday with maybe something called Thankful Thursday, where every Thursday of the month, you post something that your school community is thankful for. So getting creative there, there's so much you can do on social media across the board, whether it's, you know, photos of students, photos of faculty, maybe it's a talking head video, like Mia had mentioned earlier, of, you know, sharing what your students, faculty, and community are thankful for in terms of your school. There's a lot you can play around with here. I would say that it's not too much as long as you stick with that typical cadence that we always say of maybe 1 to 2 times per week on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn, and, you know, 5 or more times a day on Twitter if you choose to use that outlet for it. Now, I will give a note about Giving Tuesday, because obviously if you are planning something for Giving Tuesday, it's really important to, you know, celebrate your community on social and, you know, make that known. I would say on organic social media, I would say show gratitude all month long, like I had mentioned earlier, and wait to ask to give back for Giving Tuesday, because that's not something you want to be pushing constantly, but getting that ideal out there is so important as you ramp up to Giving Tuesday. So this kind of comes back to our typical 70-20-10 rule that we say for social media, and really that is 70% of your content really should be that engaging, education, community-centric content. 20% of it is shared content, whether you're sharing other posts from your community or thought leaders. 10% of that should be promotional content. So keeping that in mind as you're, you know, planning out your social media calendar this month, Giving Tuesday is so important, but there are ways that you can ramp up to it before getting to that initial, you know, ask for Giving Tuesday in your social media posts. And we'll get into that a little bit later. So I would recommend that, you know, all month long be posting in terms of that ideal of thankfulness and community and things like that. If you are interested in terms of Giving Tuesday, you know, maybe doing a paid campaign, I would consider maybe retargeting those who have visited your giving page in the last 90 days, or even just boosting a post on the day of on Giving Tuesday, just to get your message out there a little harder and make sure that you're getting in front of the eyes of your followers. But again, we'll get into that a little bit later, actually in the next episode, which we will talk about later. But I would say, you know, another piece of social media, and Mia, you touched on this earlier, is video. If you have the time, and it's not necessarily something that you have to put so much work into, but video is so important, you know, more than ever these days. You could put together a short video for your email, like Mia mentioned, but it's also a good idea for all outlets of your communications. So I would say, I think a common misconception, and I know we've talked about it in other episodes, is that video is very mistakenly thought that it always has to be beautiful, you know, paid for, done by a production company that's, you know, done beautifully. And it can be, but I would say, you know, during Thanksgiving and this time of kind of, you know, thanking your community, I would say those candid, blurry, you know, less than professional looking videos are more endearing than ever before. I think that that's what we like to see. It's very human. So whether it's a matter of asking your older students or maybe parents of younger students to shoot a quick video saying what they're thankful for, whether it's over Zoom or maybe just done with a phone if they are on campus, or asking the same of your faculty. You can splice all of this content together for a really nice, heartwarming video, or you could kind of, you know, mix up all of that content to post over the course of the entire month on social media, and it will work really well in both ways. So you could do that. I would say you could also, if you're not feeling like you're able to, you know, get your school community to actually record something, you could go into the archives, you know, put together a quick 30 seconds of clips, you know, highlighting the last year, you know, despite the pandemic, you know, celebrating all of the hard work the community has put in. That could work really well. You could also get your head of school or superintendent to actually, you know, record a video thanking the community, something that would be in that more plain text email that Mia had mentioned earlier. That could work really well. You could even go live on Giving Tuesday, which I'm sure we'll get into next week, but the opportunities are endless. I think if you can take one thing away, it would be to make sure that you're planning out your content this entire month. Don't let it go to the last minute of whether it is Giving Tuesday or Thanksgiving. If you start planning now, you'll have a wealth of content, you know, to go through the entire month. So I know, Mia, this is all very digital. I know we talked about email, social media, video, but what can schools really put together that are really that, you know, tangible piece of takeaway content that they can create during this time?
Yeah, and I love this topic. And I think, you know, when I think back to the spring and everyone was forced to get super creative for graduations and retirements and for private schools, you know, giving out acceptance letters, everyone got really creative. And even at our school marketing day last week, I heard lots of different creative things that schools were doing, like a drive-through author book signing, and all different sorts of ways to get their community together. So I think that if you have the time and you have the resources and you feel like your community needs some type of uplifting moment, I think now is the time to put something together if you can, right? And I think, you know, there's a few different things that we can consider. So if your school or district is entirely virtual, I think more than ever, people want to see each other and get together and be celebrated in some way, shape, or form. And unfortunately, COVID is still, you know, putting a damper on that. So I think that if schools could do some type of drive-through gratitude parade, where parents and teachers and students alike can get together and give their thanks and make signs and paint their cars and celebrate one another in some type of drive-through event. Now, Kristen, you have this great idea of almost like a drive-through pep rally. Maybe it could be a way to gear up the gratitude drive-through, but an opportunity where people could kind of drive through. Maybe they get some pom-poms, they get some swag, they get a hoodie, they get some hats, whatever it may be. You know, they get some snacks, and that way they can kind of drive through in full spirit and really just see one another and wave. And, you know, maybe everyone can write something that they're grateful for on the outside of their car. Just a way to get everyone together and see each other and just remind everyone that's, you know, kind of been virtual. Hey, like, we're all still here. We all are still so grateful for this community. And like, we just can't wait to be together in person. I think for a school that's virtual, operating purely virtual, if you can send an email or post on social media, obviously that's still great, like if that's all you can do. But I think for our schools that are fully virtual, trying to get together to do something in person will be key. And now for our districts, you can do it at the district level, or you could also do it at the individual school level. However, that would work depending on the size of your district. Now, of course, we have our schools that are operating in a hybrid model. So they are seeing them, you know, each other sometimes in their home sometimes. Sending home some care packages on the days that they actually come into school, just again, to show their gratitude for showing up every day. And again, we want to see something maybe different here for students than we would for teachers. So maybe for our students, we're sending home a card that says we're thankful for them adapting, you know, and accepting the changes that have been brought on this school year. Maybe we send them home with a recipe to try. Maybe some COVID-friendly snacks, or even just, you know, a cookie cutter can be fun, a turkey-shaped cookie cutter. Really get creative here and even get in the school spirit. And again, think back on what your school's mission is and what your school's authentic voice is, and try to put something together that speaks to your community. But I think that if you could send home just a little grab bag with students, or if you don't want to do that for students, because let's say, you know, you might be a district with 80,000 kids. If it's easy to do that for your teachers, then send it home for your teachers and do something different for your students. Maybe it's just that printed card that has a recipe on it or something like that. But again, sending home that tangible piece for those students that are in person, I think it's a little bit, it adds that little bit extra of like a little bit of love that I think everyone needs this time of year. And then, of course, for our schools that are operating entirely in person, you can really do anything. You can kind of proceed as normal and just switch up your messaging to make sure it's tailored to the times, change it up by your audiences. I even think that people who are in person would appreciate some type of tangible thing to come home, or, of course, some type of drive-through event. I know schools, you know, they're operating sometimes in like these small clusters where, you know, different groups of people can get together. And I think that's great. But I also feel like when those same groups of people are constantly getting together, I think you still have that craving to kind of see your entire school community together again. And I feel like what better time to do it than the holidays? What better time to do it, you know, than Thanksgiving, as a way to say, you know, we're so grateful, you know, for all that we've been through this year. And gosh, it doesn't look like it's looking ending anytime soon. So, you know, just thanking people for that and their patience during this time of year is so important. So whatever you decide to do, it's uniquely you. There's no right or wrong here. If you just send a plain text email, make sure your messaging is on point and segmented. If you just post on social media, make sure that you're honoring your community all month long. Don't just post on one day. Don't just post a happy Thanksgiving graphic on Thanksgiving. Like, you have an entire community to be thankful for. So make sure you dig deep there. And then, of course, if you want to go above and beyond and do something that's tangible and in person and memorable, do that too, or do everything, just depending on what your resources are. But I feel like, you know, it's one of those things where it's like, just don't not do anything. It's really such an important time to celebrate your community. So with that being said, next week, we're going to be talking about some best practices for Giving Tuesday, which I know Kristen alluded to a little bit. Now, Giving Tuesday is the Tuesday after Thanksgiving, and it's actually in December this year. What we don't want to see is your school or district go radio silent all of November, and then all of a sudden, the only thing we're talking about is Giving Tuesday. So I think all of the content that gets posted this month of November is in a way to remind everyone when you go to promote Giving Tuesday what they're actually giving back to. So before we can even talk about that, we really need to make sure that we have our messaging down for the month of November. But we're going to share some really good tips about form management, website management, social media ads, and all those amazing pieces that can help bring your Giving Tuesday campaign to life and help make it a super successful virtual fundraising event. So we'll be talking about that next Monday. In the meantime, I already linked up that complete social media calendar below here on Facebook. So be sure to grab your copy. It has over 100 ideas from the brilliant Kristen here. And I know so many people have already found that so helpful. So be sure to grab your free copy. And other than that, thank you so much for joining us for this week's School Marketing Show. And we look forward to seeing you again, same place, same time next week.
Thanks, everyone.